बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। आई एम ओवर हेयर अगेन विद यू विद द थर्ड लेक्चर रिलेटेड टू द चैप्टर लिटिल बाय लिटिल वन बॉक्स फोर। इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर आई हैव गिवन यू आउट द कंप्लीट ग्रामेटिकल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ ऑल दीज ग्रामेटिकल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स which are in front of you over here on the board. And in the next lecture related to the chapter little by little one box four, I have explained all the passages one by one and I have given you out the complete grammatical descriptions of all the important words from these passages. Instead of all these things, we have discussed the block questions also. Now in this lecture I will give you a detailed note on the exercise and we will discuss all the contents that are present in the exercise. Now I am coming to towards the first content, that is the vocabulary, and they have given you out some words and they have asked you to write the meanings of these words as used in the lesson. I have given you out the synonyms and the meanings of all the words with sentences that are important from the chapter, and these words, these specific words that are present in the exercise are over here on the screen. You can take a look of all these words with their meanings over here and you can grasp out all these meanings. But this, the most important thing is that you have to go back to my lecture and you have to memorize and learn all the important words, because in the paper they can ask any word from the chapter. Now I am coming towards the next activity related to the vocabulary, in which they have given you out some phrases and they have asked you to tell us the meanings of those phrases. So I have given you out the meaning of all these phrases over here and I am going to explain these meanings in front of you. The first is a long bumpy ride. This phrase means that he faces many difficulties in the life. The second one is earned first place. The meaning of this phrase is that the author works hard and got the first position in every competition or contest. The third one is a well-rounded student. This phrase means that the author participated in all co-curricular activities. That is why he is called a well-rounded student. The fourth phrase is along with a group of other students. This phrase means that author did not take any class alone. To look forward to it. This phrase means that the author did not worry about the future but he looks forward to it. The last one is made it this far. This phrase means that his experience of jobs made his life more mature and responsible. Okay student, in the next activity related to the vocabulary, they have asked you to translate out the first passage of the unit. I have not translated any passage related to any chapter in front of you because the translation is already available in our channel. So you can go back to towards our channel and you can take out the translation of all the passages with their meanings, with their word by word translation and with their sentence translation. But I am going to give you the translation of first passage specifically over here on the screen. You can see this translation. If you want to prepare only the translation of this passage, then you can take help from this one. But if you want to prepare the translation of all the passages, and this is necessary to prepare all the translation, so you can you have to go to our channel and you have to take help from this one. So student, next activity is related to reading comprehension. You have read out the complete chapter, and now they have given you out questions and they have given you out some options and you have to pick out the right option for all these sentences. So now I am going to explain and solve this activity in front of you. Here on the screen you can see that the first sentence is, the last couple of years have been a long bumpy ride for me, as they have for everyone of my age. The underlined phrase means the correct option is B, a hard and challenging time. Now I am coming towards the second question. The author thinks he will become a well-rounded student by partaking both in academic and co-curricular activities. So C1 is the right answer. The third one is, his summer jobs in the preceding 2 years helped him to get financial boost. The fourth one activity is, the author has become more dash because of his job experience, more mature and responsible because of his job experiences. This developing positive outlook has given the author the motivation he needs to become successful. So students, this solution will surely help you to understand and to choose the correct option. Now I am coming towards the question answers related to the chapter. I have discussed all the block questions one by one related to the passages in the previous lecture, and now I am going to discuss the questions that are present in the exercise. The first question is, what are the some distinctions of the writer? Some distinctions of the writers are Qaid-e-Azam badge in scouting, winner of Who is Who quiz program at district level, and academic excellence award while participating in inter-district declamation contest and essay writing competition for the year 2011. Now I'm coming towards the second question. How has the writer spent his summer vacation? The writer spent his summer vacation doing different types of jobs for financially support. Third question is, what has he gained from his summer jobs experiences? The jobs experiences prepared him mentally and financially sound and made him to understand the importance of independence. The fourth question is, how are these experiences helpful to him in the future? Answer is, these experiences helpful for him by making more mature and responsible, which helps him not to be worried about the future but to look forward at it. What kind of student is the writer? Which of his qualities impress you? He is a well-rounded student, he is a mature and responsible person, his spirit of hard-working, strong determination and excellent co-curricular achievements impressed me so much. The question, the answer of the last question can be changed out, and you can add or delete some type of things. If you want to delete or add any other thing about the writer in this question, you can add it out. Now I'm coming towards the next activity. The next activity is related to the grammar, and I have given you out all the grammatical concepts over here, but the activity is related to the first grammatical concept, indefinite pronoun, and they have given you out some sentences, and they have to called you out that you have to underline the indefinite pronouns from all these sentences. I have given you out these sentences over here, and I have told you all the indefinite pronouns, that which words come in the category of indefinite pronouns. So I have underlined all these indefinite pronouns in front of you. You can take help from this activity from here, as it is in the solved form. Okay students, the next activity is related to your subject verb agreement. Yes, they have given you out the sentences, and they have to, you have to pick out the appropriate verb according to the subject, and this activity is also in the solved form over here on the screen. And if there is any type of other sentence which you have to deal in this context, then you have to go back to my grammar lecture related to this chapter, and you have to learn all the rules one by one, as I have given you out 9 rules that comprise the subject verb agreement. So you have to go back and learn and memorize and understand the subject verb agreement completely, so that you can be able to understand and to handle out all the sentences like this. So the solved activity is over here on the screen. You can take this solution and you can absorb it out. Okay students, the next activity is related to the present perfect tense. They have given you out the verbs in the black brackets, and they have given you out the sentences, and you have to use this verb in the form of present perfect tense in the sentences. I have given you out the solution of these sentences over here on the screen, but I have explained you out this tense in short and in a summarized form in a chart in the previous lecture. You can take help from that one to understand the concept completely. Okay students, now I am coming towards the writing skills. And in writing skills, you have to write a precis of paragraph number 2. The precis of paragraph 2 is over here on the screen. You have to precise this paragraph. I have given you out the contents and the objectives and the writing skills which you have to follow while you have to write the precis in the previous lectures related to the chapter first aid for writing a precis. And here I have given you out the precis of paragraph number 2 in front of you, and they have asked you to write out an essay on the extracurricular activities, on the importance of extracurricular activities. This essay is over here in front of you. You can take help from this essay, and you can add or delete some amount of material, and you can add quotations to make it more impressive and more enhancing, so that it will help you to be prepared for you in the for the paper. So students, this lecture, this comprehending lecture, these three lectures related to this chapter are really informative, and you have taken out, no doubt, a lot of things and a lot of information from me by following me. So students, now I will be with you with my next chapter as soon as possible, and in which we will discuss same scheme of study and we will analyze this chapter in the same way. Till then you have to wait for me. I will be with you inshallah ta'ala. Allah Hafiz.